Hi everyone, Steve Patterson here again from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, I show you how to add color effects to your image using the hidden color grading presets in Photoshop. In a previous video, I showed you how to color grade images using gradient maps, and I covered everything you need to know to create your own custom color effects. But Photoshop also includes color grading presets, or what Adobe calls photographic toning presets, and in this video, I show you how to use them. The photographic toning presets are a set of gradients, and they've been included with Photoshop's other gradients since back in CS6. But in Photoshop 2020, Adobe added a ton of new gradients, and to make room, all of the classic gradients, including the photographic toning presets, were moved to a new location. So in this video, I'll show you where to find the presets in the latest versions of Photoshop and how to use them to add great-looking color effects with a single click. To follow along, you'll need Photoshop 2020 or later. I'm using 2022. Let's get started. You can follow along with your own image. I'll use this one from Adobe Stock. Now, the photographic toning presets are meant to be used with a gradient map. But before we can add the gradient map, we first need to load the gradients. And these days, we load them from the gradients panel. If you're not seeing the gradients panel, go up to the window menu in the menu bar and choose gradients. But if you see a check mark next to its name, it means the panel is already open and selecting it here will close it. So the gradients panel holds all of the new gradients that were added back in Photoshop 2020, and they're all divided into groups. You can twirl the group open to see the gradients inside it. But the older gradients, including the photographic toning presets, need to be loaded separately. So to load them, click the gradients panel menu icon and choose Legacy Gradients. Then scroll down to the bottom and a new Legacy Gradients group will appear. Twirl the group open, and inside are all of Photoshop's classic gradients, again divided into groups. And the group we're looking for is Photographic Toning. Open the group, and here we find all of the color grading presets. Now, because these presets were designed to be used with a gradient map, we can't just apply them directly to the image. If I drag one of the presets from the gradients panel onto the image, it fills the entire document because Photoshop applies it as a gradient fill adjustment layer. So I'll delete the adjustment layer by dragging it onto the trash bin. Instead, we need to add a gradient map adjustment layer. So in the Layers panel, click the new Fill or Adjustment Layer icon and choose Gradient Map from the list. The gradient map appears as an adjustment layer above the image. And by default, the gradient map converts the image to black and white. I cover how gradient maps work in much more detail both in my previous color grading video and in a separate video where I show you how to create high contrast black and white images, and you'll find links to both videos in the description. The gradient that the gradient map is currently using appears in the preview bar in the properties panel. Right now, it's using a black to white gradient, but we want to use our photographic toning presets. So to choose a different gradient, open the gradient picker by clicking the arrow next to the preview bar. Don't click the preview bar itself, or you'll open the gradient editor, which we don't need. Instead, just click the arrow. And in the gradient picker, you'll find the same list of gradients that we saw in the gradients panel. Scroll down to the bottom to get to the Legacy Gradients group. Then twirl the group open and scroll down to the Photographic Toning presets. I'm seeing my presets as small thumbnails. You may be seeing large thumbnails, in which case you can click the gear icon and choose Small. But the problem with these thumbnails is that a lot of them look very similar, and it's hard to really tell what they do. So a better way to view the presets is to click the gear icon and choose Small List. And now we can see their actual names. And to view more presets at once, you can resize the gradient picker by dragging the bottom right corner. Now, I'm seeing a bit of a glitch here on my screen, and I'm not sure what's causing that, so I'll click outside the gradient picker to close it. And then I'll click the arrow to reopen it, and now everything looks good. So most of the photographic toning presets are variations of just a handful of colors, like blue and cyan, red, orange, and brown, including sepia, since these colors tend to work well for color grading. And you can click on any preset to try it out. So here we have different sepia effects, some blues and cyans, gold, copper, and lots more. There's even some nice black and white effects with the selenium presets. An easy way to try them all out is to just click on one and then use the up and down arrow keys on your keyboard to scroll through them. Now, not all of the presets will look good when you first select them. If I choose the gold copper preset, it looks pretty harsh, with lots of color banding in different areas. But I'll choose it for now so I can show you how to make it look better. The reason it looks so bad is because, by default, gradient maps completely replace the photo's original colors with the colors from the preset. If I turn the gradient map off by clicking its visibility icon, we see the original colors. And if I turn it back on, we see the preset's colors. But instead of replacing the colors, what we usually want to do is blend the colors together. And one way to do that is to lower the opacity of the gradient map adjustment layer. I'll lower the opacity from 100% down to 40%. So now I'm mixing 40% of the preset's colors with 60% of the original colors, and this gives me a much better result. Again, here's the original image and the image with the preset's colors blended in. Another way to blend the preset with the image is by changing the gradient map's blend mode. I'll set the opacity back to 100%. Now, the two blend modes that tend to work best with color grading are color and soft light. So I'll click on the blend mode option and change it from normal to color. The color blend mode keeps the brightness of the original image and blends only the color from the preset. And this helps to reduce the banding issues we were seeing with the normal blend mode. So here's what the normal blend mode looked like. And here's color. Again, normal and color. And we can still lower the opacity of the gradient map to help blend the colors even further. The other blend mode to try is soft light. I'll again set the opacity back to 100%. And then I'll change the blend mode to soft light. The advantage with soft light is that not only does it blend the colors, but it also increases contrast by making the shadows darker and the highlights brighter. So if we compare all three blend modes, here's the original with normal, and here's color, and here's soft light. In this case, I think soft light looks best. And of course, you can adjust it even further by lowering the gradient map's opacity. To try a different preset, just go back to the Properties panel, click the arrow to open the Gradient Picker, and then choose a different one. For this image, I'll go with the Gold 2 preset. And I'll lower the opacity to 40%. And there we have it! That's where to find and how to use the color grading presets in Photoshop. Be sure to check out my previous color grading video to learn how to create your own custom color effects. And if you liked this video, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to my channel to learn more about Photoshop. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.